Hello, in this video I'm going to demonstrate to you how to use the Active Directory sites in a virtual environment and to test certain functionality that you wouldn't be able to normally test because it requires a vast amount of networks and other things. So Active Directory bases its information of sites on subnets. So subnets have a one-to-one mapping with the Active Directory sites. So what I'm going to do is go into the administrator tools on this domain controller and open the Sites and Services console and show you how I'm going to create a new site and associate that with a subnet. So by default, when you do the installation of Active Directory on a server machine, there is only one site that is created, and it's called the default first site name. The idea with sites and subnets and the link objects that connect these to each other is that your replication traffic, the propagation of objects and changes to those objects and new objects and other things, is done through these links. If you don't change this configuration and keep adding domain controllers to your Active Directory, what's going to happen is every server will be a member of the default first site name, and this obviously is one site, and every server can automatically create a connection to another domain controller in the environment, and everybody can send data to any other domain controller in the environment. Now there are certain instances where you wouldn't want this, because if let's say you have an environment where you have 40 different physical sites, and let's say that all these the 39 of these sites have a star sort of topology to the main site, so they have a connection to the main site and they do not have any connections between each other, and they connect to each other over the main site, then you don't want any of the child sites sending each other data directly, because that doesn't reflect your network configuration. When you create the links and the subnets and the sites, what you're doing is you're basically controlling the flow of data, and you're also controlling the schedule and the bandwidth that will be used for these Active Directory traffic. In an environment where you have many services that depend on the Active Directory infrastructure, like Exchange and other Microsoft application servers, it is critical that you specify the sites and the subnets and know how to configure these objects. In this demonstration, I'm going to trick Active Directory into thinking that there is another actual physical site by playing around with the subnet information. For Active Directory, it's just the definition of an IP network, and the subnet mask is enough for defining a subnet and then associating that with a site. So to make myself more clearer, what I'm going to do is, by default, as you can see, there are no subnets, because Active Directory doesn't go around the domain controllers and check their IP configuration and then use that as a basis for creating subnets. It just doesn't do that. There is a default IP link, default IP site link here, and then there's a default first site name, and it just uses this information to configure replication. I'm going to go ahead and just rename this, and you can rename it. I'm going to name it which city do we want to visit. I'm going to just name it Beijing, and I'm going to show you how I configured the IP, the internet protocol on this machine. So as you can see, this machine has two Ethernet adapters. It's a virtual machine on VMware. One of the adapters is 1200, and it's on the 192.168.1.0 network, as you can see from the subnet mask. And there's another adapter, which is the local network. That's the 20 network, and the IP address there is 2200. So What I'm going to do is I'm going to associate all of these with a given subnet, and the prefix for this subnet will be I'm going to select the site, and I'm going to explain myself, you know, what I'm doing here right now. So what I've just done is I've used the network ID of the internet connection of this domain controller, which is the 10 network, and I've said 192.168.10/24, which means use the 24 bits of the 32-bit subnet mask, which translates to 255s. So this 24 here is the CIDR, the clusters inter-domain routing notation, and it will be translated to this when you look at it in octets. So I've specified that and selected a site, and I've associated the subnet with a site, and what's going to happen is once I've created this information, which can be changed later on, but the thing is, once I've specified this information, if there is another domain controller in the environment that will have an IP address from the 10 network, let's say its address will be 1100, then what's going to happen is Active Directory, the DC Promo installation wizard, will automatically place that domain controller in the Beijing site. Okay. Click OK there. And I'm going to create another site, and we will name that Pretoria, which is another beautiful city I'd like to see before I die. It notifies me about the fact that there is no subnet associated with this site that I've just created. We will do that, no worries. Create a new subnet, and I'm going to do a special trick here. 201.32. Okay. So this is something that I can do. I just wanted to show you that that you can do this, but it's not very useful. So this 201 will be the IP address of my secondary DC here. Check the mouse pointer, it's the TT secondary DC. Okay? When you give that TT secondary DC 201 and specify the configuration as here, what's going to happen is when you install the Active Directory on the TT secondary DC, it will automatically be placed under the Pretoria site. So once the configuration is in place, if you've got the subnets and the sites configured, associated correctly as you want them, as they are in the physical network environment, then Active Directory DC Promo Installation Wizard will just check that information and use that information to put the domain controller in the right site during the AD installation. Okay, so you can play around with this, and you could say, you're going to use a 28-bit subnet, and then what this will do is it will use a subnet of 2255s and the 240, which basically means that you got only 4 bits left in the hosts section, which makes something like 2 to the 4, which is 8, 16. You can specify 16 domain controllers in this subnet. So what I'm talking about here could be cryptic to some of you, and the reason would be that you don't know about subnetting in the IP protocol. I recommend that you check out one of our videos on that and see how this is done, the classless inter-domain routing and subnetting video, and you can get a better idea of how this is done and how we calculate these hosts and subnets and network IDs and everything in the IP version 4 protocol. To complicate things further, you can use the IP version 6 protocol. We are still not using it in many enterprise networks, so it still looks like it's far away, but I've been seeing many people implement this. So it's a good idea to understand the IPv6 notation as well at the same time. So if you need to configure AD with the IPv6 protocol in the future, Microsoft Windows is fully aware of it, and many of the user interfaces in the operating system have been changed to reflect the new protocol, the new addressing protocol as well. So going to click OK. As you can see, by default these are the servers. This is one interesting setting here, and if you go into the server and then expand it to go to its NTDS settings container and go to the properties of that, you can see that the global catalog setting for a domain controller is specified here. So you need to change that. You would specify that here. It's a good idea to make sure that it's not the last one, because there must at least be one global catalog in a domain, even though they're not of much use in a single domain environment. So this was a quick rough discussion of the Active Directory sites and services. Probably in the future we'll do more videos on how to configure the site links and schedules and other things like that. Thank you for listening.